Okay, shh, silence. Now, the heading of this is the deficiencies in existing system. Okay, so we are trying to understand what had happened in history, deficiencies that we had in existing system from a part A trader's perspective. In India or in any country, usually business are divided into this part. Either you can start your business as a manufacturer, right, or you can be a trader, or you can be a service provider, right? And then finally you people are consumer, and then there will be role of government in all these areas. Okay, so we have three types of assesses in indirect tax. Can you tell me three types of assesses in indirect tax? Manufacturer assessee, trader assessee, and service provider assessee. First, we are trying to understand what had happened with a trader up to 30th June 2017, and then we will understand in GST what is happening with a trader in 2017. Obviously, for a trader, 2017 will be better than 2016, up to 2016, or it will be worse than earlier law. You tell me the changes that they propose in India are better or worse? Obviously better, because it will help country to grow, and country can grow only when businesses in India are growing, right? And our objective is to help a trader with a new system of taxation. Are we clear about our objective with a trader? Acha, are we helping consumer? Yes, directly or indirectly we are helping consumers, and that's what I'm going to prove here now. See, there are different point of taxation. Allow me to complete my chart first, and then only you will start writing, because when you will write in your notebook, I do not want that without applying brain you should write it. No, the moment I complete my chart, then you should do at your own and cross confirm it with the chart on board. Okay, I'll give you enough time. So now currently please do not write anything, just try to understand this. Okay, now I'm trying to teach you the oldest tax system in India. Now, trader will pay manufacturing tax, service tax, or sales tax? Trader earlier will pay which tax? Excise duty? Is he manufacturing? No. All right. Will he pay service tax? Is it a service provider? No. Obviously, he'll pay which tax? Sales tax. And sales tax can apply only on sale of goods. Only on? So you should understand what do you mean by goods, and you should understand what do you mean by sale. Sale of goods means, first of all, movable and marketable property. Goods means what? Movable and marketable. Am I moving from one place to another place? Yes. Am I movable? Yes. Am I marketable?
No.
Yeah. Marker. Is it movable? Is it marketable?
Yes.
Yes, position can be transferred from one person to another. Ownership can transfer from one person to another. So I give this marker to this nalayak ladki, okay? Just for use of one day. Is she owner of this marker?
No.
Will she pay sales tax?
No.
Why? Because only possession is transferred. Then she should pay service tax. Because I am allowing her to use my goods for consideration. Obviously, I will not allow her use my goods without any consideration. So, if it is not a sale, then it is higher. On higher, we had service tax. Sale means what, sir? Marker, prepare a bill, write her name in invoice, buyer, seller, stamp, her sign, my sign, okay. Contract executed. Alright, consideration taken. That contract was sale contract. In sale, we transfer all risk and reward attached to goods along with the goods. Am I clear? Sale means all risk and reward has been transferred to one person, from one person to another person. That means sales tax was a transaction-based tax. Sale tax was transaction-based tax. Alright, that means we should have two people to apply sales tax. Seller, buyer. Alright, and what was the event they were taxing, what kind of transaction they were taxing? Sale of goods, not a sale, because sale of immovable property will be there, which will not have sales tax effect. Why? Because immovable properties are not good. Why? Goods means what?
Movable
and marketable. Can we sell immovable properties also? Can we sell immobile properties? Yes, we sell building, we can sell land. But will there be any sales tax levy on sale of immobile property? No. Why? Because immobile properties are not goods. There, I am giving you hint. GST is applicable on land and building or not? What is the name of GST Act? Service, you understand. Rental agreement, leasing agreement. It is taxable. What is goods? Movable and marketable. That means if I transfer immovable property tomorrow, should I pay GST on it? No, because GST is not applicable on immovable property. Why, sir? Because immovable property is not a goods. See, this is how you should understand. Alright? So, trader pays the sales tax on event. What is the event of trader? He pays sales tax on sale of goods. So you should understand these two words. What is sale and what is goods? Sale means transfer of risk plus reward. That means ownership as well as possession. And goods means movable plus marketable. Are we clear with basics? See, these basics were valid in old law. The moment this happens, there will be levy of sales tax. Okay, this is a sales tax charging section. Now, you are a government representative now. Your job is controlling tax systems in India. You tell me, it is easy to collect tax from retailer or tax from manufacturer. So, this is a chain. Manufacturer will make a goods. Manufacturer will have their dedicated distributors. Distributors will give goods to wholesalers. Wholesaler will give good to retailer, and ultimate final consumer will go to shop to buy that goods. So retailer, consumer will always buy goods from retailer. Now everybody in this chart is a customer, but everybody in this chart is not consumer. Okay, and that's why we say that every consumer is a customer, but every customer need not to be a consumer. Okay, yeah. So, are we clear about basics now? Now, you tell me, if you are a government authority, in old system, 1970s, 1980s, that time, was it easy to collect tax? Were we having computers? Were we having any, you know, advanced system of tax collection people? So many ITOs and assessing officers and department and inspectors. That means we were having only few offices, few sales tax commissioner and officers. And you have to manage whole India. Now, is it easy to collect tax from retailer or manufacturer? I'm giving you two choices. Now, number of assessees you should count. Am I clear? Yeah. So, quantity wise, do we have more manufacturers in India or we have more retailers in India? And more retailers mean difficult to manage. But more manufacturers, less manufacturers means easy to manage. And one more hint, manufacturer is already registered in one of the central law. Which law is that? Excise. And excise was tough. Excise people were advanced people. Sales, this is state, no, this is happening at state level. Sales tax was applicable on state level. But excise was applicable at central level. That means if you manufactured the goods and stock is not available in your factory now, then what happened? If you manufactured 1000 goods, and now stock is only 200. What happened with 800 goods? Obviously sale, sir. That means, was it easy to catch manufacturer? Was it easy to catch manufacturer if you don't pay sales tax? See, he cannot evade in excise duty. Assume that. He cannot evade excise duty. Why? Because excise people were very strict. Excise department was advanced department. Because that is central department. But state department was a weak department. But is it easy to catch this particular manufacturer? Yes. Why? Because already one law was on them. Right? So if they want to comply with excise, they had to comply with sales tax. And that's why the first tax system that we launched in India was the first point taxation. First system that we launched in India is first point taxation. That means in this whole chain, only first the trader will pay taxes. Now, as a manufacturer, you produce goods to consume or to sell. That means manufacturer were paying two taxes, beta. Excise on manufacturing and sales tax on sales tax. So, double taxation on same goods? No. They were not calling it double taxation. Why? Because who is manufacturing, who is taking excise duty? Central government on manufacturing. Different, even different law. Who is taking sales tax? State government. Different event, different tax. How can you call double taxation? Two taxes. Two different taxes cannot be called as? This is how they are fooling our traders. Trader were paying. See, as a trader, I was paying same taxes, two taxes on these goods. One is form of excise and one is form of sales tax. Okay? But was it a case of double taxation that we discussed? No. It wasn't a case of double taxation. So what happened in this scenario, you know? Here if you see, cost I am taking nil here. Now obviously manufacturer will not have nil cost, but I don't want to increase my chart. Okay? That means whatever value addition we have done in this particular goods. What is value addition? You are done with costing, right? Basis of costing. If I want to manufactured a product, I should bring raw material. I should bring labor. I should bring overheads. Right? Then admin overhead, then I'm selling overhead, then these goods will be manufactured and sold, right? Whatever I do with these goods is known as value addition. So I put plastic in a machinery, value addition. I applied my labor on it, value addition. I applied overhead on it, value addition. Am I clear? So manufacturer do all kind of value addition and that is 100 rupees. Are we clear about? So what is the cost or, you know, value addition done by manufacturer on this product? 100. And what point of taxation we are discussing? First point. That means only first trader. I am saying first trader. Sir, manufacturer. No, he is also trader. Every seller is? Trader. So he sells goods, right? So he becomes? Trader. Every trader shall apply sales tax on this value. Okay? Now who will apply sales tax? Manufacturer. At a rate of 10%, I am taking 10 rupees. Calculation I am keeping very easy because concept is important, not numbers. Okay. What will be the invoice value as a consumer or as a customer? How much will you pay for these goods? 110. Sir, how 110? 100 rupees value of goods plus 10 rupees tax. This is how you see invoice. So this is your invoice. This is your invoice. Value of goods 100 rupees plus sales tax 10%. 10 rupees is equal to invoice value that you should pay. 110. What is the cost of distributor? How much money he paid? 110. Are you paid how much, Nalayak? 110. Okay. Sir, what is value addition here? I am putting 90 rupees. Sir, what kind of value addition your distributor will do? See, distributor will also have his expenses, no? Freight, transportation, loading and unloading, admin department, selling department, marketing. That means every trader will have, every distributor will have some value addition to this respect of these goods. Along with his profit, value addition includes profit also. So he is ready to sell these goods at 200 rupees. Why 200 rupees? 110 he purchased and 90 rupees is own value addition. So he is ready to sell these goods at 200 rupees. Will he charge any tax here? No. Why? Because, sir, this is a first point taxation. That means only first the dealer will pay tax. Alright, so what is the invoice value? 200. Now I am not putting my energy into it. 200, his value addition 80 rupees. 280 rupees he is to sell. Is there any tax? No, sir. That means invoice value will be 280. Right, retailer will buy this goods at 280. He will add his value addition 70. Total 350. No tax. He will sell these goods to 350. As a consumer, you will buy these goods for 350. Government will get 10 rupees. You tell me what is the drawback in this sales tax system? What is the drawback? Sales tax was supposed to be on sales price. Sales tax was supposed to be paid by final consumer. Now consumer is getting goods at what price, beta? That means technically 35 rupees was the tax amount. It was supposed to be a tax amount. But government is getting only 10 rupees. Why? Because government is a cozy government, lazy government. They don't have enough control on my retailer because retailer is in every building, every street here. I'm unable to control retailer because retailer is not registered in any law. Retailer is not registered in... Sir, why was it easy to collect from manufacturer? because this 4 lakh was already registered in excise, some labor laws, industrial laws. And manufacturer means big company. They are having chartered accountant, they are having cost accountant. Retailer next to this building. Do you think that this guy is having in-house chartered accountant and cost accountant and company secretary? Obviously, are you, no, this is the problem. You should understand problem. Then only you will understand and appreciate GST system. Are we clear? So was it easy to collect tax from this person? Sales tax is on sales. Sale price is 350. But government was getting only 10. Now as a government people, you are happy or sad?
Sad.
Sad. And that's a demerit, no? Low tax collection. What is the demerit? What is the demerit? Low revenue. Low revenue to government. Okay? What is the merit? What is the merit of this system? Low tax evasion. Why low tax evasion? Because manufacturer only 1% pays, and there were hardly few manufacturers in India. Sales tax department can literally go and sit in the factory of manufacturer. Are we clear? But this system was not good system for the country, so we need to change the system. So technically, who should pay tax in this system? Sales tax. We are talking about sales tax. Who should pay sales tax? Not like consumer, but indirect tax, no. If I ask consumer to go and pay tax, do you think that consumer is so polite he'll go and pay tax? That means last point. Retailer should pay tax. Sir, but it is difficult to control him. Are we will hire new offices. We will expand our income, sales tax department. We will do raid. We will arrest few traders. We'll put them behind the bar. We'll teach them a lesson. We'll impose penalty. Okay. Ignorance of law cannot be an excuse. This retailer cannot say, I don't know what is sales tax. I'm illiterate person. You are earning profit, no? Then you are not illiterate. And if you are illiterate, hire a chartered accountant. At least you know chartered accountants are there in this world. Every dealer knows this. Every businessman knows this, that there are some taxes that we have to pay. Even if you are an illiterate one. Right? So they say that what happens? Nalak? Something happened. What they bring? Last point. As a government people, you bring last point, taxation. Again, cost plus value addition. Okay, cost plus value addition. Okay, this is subtotal. On that, we will add sales tax at the rate of 10%. Okay, and then it will give us invoice value. Okay, what is the cost here? Nil. What is the value addition? Now, I am keeping data same. What is the value addition done by manufacturer? 100. He is ready to sell at 100. And he will sell at 100. Why? Because he will not charge any tax now. Because he is not a final seller. What is the cost for this guy? Sorry. 100. What is value addition done? 90. He is ready to sell at 90. He will sell at 190. Right? What is the cost for this guy? 190. His value addition? 80. What is the value? 270. He is ready at 270. He will sell at 270. What is the cost for him? 270. What is the value addition? 70. He is ready to sell at 340. But he cannot sell at 340. He have to charge 34 and he can sell only at 374. Alright, now in this system, how much government got? 34. What is the final price of goods? 374. Now you tell me merits. First demerit, because we are concerned about demerit of this system. High tax.
Tax burden.
Evasion. No, it's not burden. High tax, evasion. Why? The biggest demerit is high tax. Evasion. Because this retailer is not a serious person. And you say that we will impose penalty, or he doesn't know that there is an existence of sales tax. How can you expect that this person know that there is a penalty in sales tax act? Right? So, and India judicial system, you already know. Even if SELTA department read this premises, what department, what this guy will do? Give 100 rupees, 500 rupees? Settle the case. That means people were scared about income tax department, SELTA department? No. Obviously no. Right? Because there wasn't any control from a government angle even on department. Even department should be under control, right? Department, we are not having any control here. That's why high tax evasion. But what is the best part about this, you know? They were getting not high. It's not high. Moderate. Or you can say, you know, this optimum revenue. It's not high, it's not low, it's a fair revenue. Why? Because what is the selling price? 340. And according to 10%, 34. So I say optimum tax to tax revenue. Optimum tax revenue. It's not high, it's not low. But sir, it is inflationary in nature. See, no product feature has been changed. Government just changed the system price from first point to, because of change in government policy, my commodity price has changed. Okay, sir, only change by some extra rupee. We were paying 350 rupees, now we are paying how much? Only 24 rupees change, sir. Beta, for you it is only 24. For India as a whole, it can be in crores. It can be of lakhs crores now, in today's scenario. Alright? So, 129 crore population we are talking about here. So, 24 rupees each day, each person means overall effect you can see. Sure? Yeah? So, my numbers are small numbers, but government number will not be in the rupees. It will mean lakhs crores. So, this system is also failed system. So what system you will bring? Now you are angry government or normal government? Because you launched last point system, but people are not paying tax. Earlier you were getting 10 rupees at least. Low, but you are getting it. Now we are waiting for mere Karan Arjun aayenge, tax bharenge. Karan Arjun aayenge, tax bharenge. Na Karan aaya, na Arjun aaya. So you are angry government now. You will say, now every dealer shall pay sales tax. And that point they launch by calling it as multi-point system. They launch multi-point tax. Sir, what is multi-point tax? Again, I am writing here. Cost. Understand that even if it is not visible. Plus value addition. Okay. Subtotal plus sales tax at 10%, and that will be my invoice value. Now you tell me, what was the cost to the manufacturer? Nil. What was his value addition? He was ready to sell goods at? He will pay 10 rupees. What will be the invoice value? What is its cost? What is his value addition? He was ready to sell at 200, but he has to charge. So what is the tax invoice value? 220. What is his cost? 220. Value addition? 80. So 300. 30 rupees tax. 330. What is his cost? 330. Value addition? 70. 400. 40. 440. Yeah, right. What is the price in the hands of good? 440. What amount of taxes government got? 10 plus 20 plus 30, 60 is equal, and plus 14, 100. Oh, tell me the merits. First of all, there is a cascading effect. Second demerit, high inflation. Cascading effect and high inflation. Apart from that, many things. Now high compliance cost. There are so many demerits in this system. But one person is happy. Merit. High tax revenue. And government were not bothered about now retailer. You pay or you don't pay. my existing tax value from retailer and distributor and wholesaler is already more than my expectation. Now you tell me, as a government person, out of these three, which is the best one? No. Best one means it's not selfish one. Third one is a selfish one. You are thinking only about you. You know, you won't be elected next time. People will not vote for you. Why? Are the goods which was having available at 350 rupees, you made it at 374 and now you are making same goods available at 440. Are you mad or what? So Parle ji today 5 rupees, tomorrow 8, day after tomorrow 25. I am not eating that Parle ji. Are Parle ji can move from 4 rupees to 4.5 and then 5. This kind of price movement in the country just because of change in government policy. You are not increasing any feature in my goods. Goods is exactly same, and some trader were having two types of stock. Same biscuit, but 374. Same biscuit, 350. And same biscuit, because some stocks are there, right? So as a consumer, you will go in shop, eni chahiye. Dusra dikha, eni chahiye. Are? Because you are finding a goods with a lowest price. So, but same goods, double price, how? Because they are playing with tax system. Now this doesn't happen every day. I am saying whenever it has happened. I don't know exact years. And that is not relevant also. But this was the original scenario. When they started levying tax, then they upgraded to last point. Then they realized that last point will fail. And then angry government, multi-point. Now, what is the best tax system for both angle, win-win situation for both, government, consumer, trader, everybody? Middle one. Last point, taxation. Why last point taxation is best? Because sales tax is on sales, sale price, 10% on sale price, that means overall you should pay 34 rupees. Overall you should pay. In this system, we don't have any cascading effect. Government is getting optimum revenue. So for me, and sales tax should be paid by trader, seller, and he is a final seller. But the problem is that this guy is a nalai guy. He is not paying taxes. Then you improve your system to collect taxes from this person. You cannot punish my people, citizens of India, for mistake done by you and your traders. Sure? Are we clear about these systems? Yeah? Now solution they brought in 2000. Okay, white paper law. Solution to this particular problems. All these three problems are having demerit. My VAT was not having even a single demerits. No, theoretically it was there. But not demerit like this. So they brought something in the indirect tax system which has given them optimum revenue without inflation and with the lowest tax evasion. Tax evasion was there, but lowest, negligible, very difficult. That means my VAT system that they brought in India in 2000 was the best system. One of the best system, I must say now. Right? And from 2000, in 2000, they see up to 2000, what happened, you know, whenever central want to pass any law, we had discussed in this thing yesterday also, they will present bill in, they'll pass the act and act will be applicable to whole of India. Whenever state want to pass act, what state will do? State will prepare a bill, put it in the state legislative assembly, pass it, and that law is applicable to your state. People, you will not understand, people will traveling from one state to another state for a shopping. Why? Because same goods which is available at 20% VAT in India is available at 2% VAT in Gujarat. And Maharashtra, Gujarat is not so far. You take a fast train, go to Dahanu or Virar. From Virar, you take a train, go to Wapi. 1.5 hour maximum. From Mumbai to Wapi, alright? 1.5 or 2. Maximum in 2 hour, you are in Gujarat. Instead of buying goods from the other, go and buy in. See, Maharashtra and Gujarat, when I say two states, sir. Are they two states, but attached to each other. You stand on Maharashtra-Gujarat border, 20% tax. 2% tax. 20% tax, 2% tax. Are you are staying in Boulder? Where will you go for shopping? Obviously 2%. Now some goods were available at 2% there and 20% here. Same problem was with Gujarat. Some goods are available at 25% and available at 5% in Maharashtra. So even Gujarati buyers will come to Maharashtra. To restrict that, they started levying entry tax. To restrict this manipulation, they started levying because you purchase goods there at low price, but while entering, you will pay tax, another tax, entry tax. So to solve problem of one tax, you started taking another tax. Now people were manipulating in that also. Are they find a different route because Maharashtra, Gujarat is connected with so many areas. People were not riding their truck from highways, main highways where they know that police are there. There are many small villages from which you can cross the border. Smuggling we call it. Smuggling doesn't happen only at international level. Smuggling happens at state level. So it was happening because of VAT systems. My system was having problem. Apart from that, every state was having their own system. Some states are having first point. Some states are having last point. In last point, some states are having 10%, some 20%, some 30%. And in some states, this is not a goods. Are that is extreme one. Maharashtra, this is goods. Gujarat, this is not goods. Maharashtra, this is goods. Gujarat, this is not goods. Maharashtra, taxable goods. Gujarat, exempt goods. This problem was there. Was there any transparency in India? Sir, you will say, we are a consumer, sir, we are not bothered about it. Look at me, I am an international firm, I am Hindustan Unilever, I wanted to start my manufacturing and trading system in India. Different compliance in Maharashtra, different compliances in Gujarat, different compliances at central level, different tax rate. My two accountants committed suicide. Are and my case is going on in courts. Gujarat court as well as Maharashtra court as well as Supreme Court, because everywhere law is different. So sometime I go to Gujarat and say this is not a goods. I prove that this is not a goods. Same argument I use here and they say this is goods. Because their definition of goods is different from our definition of goods. Their law they pass Gujarat Assembly, we pass our Maharashtra Assembly Act. And centrally there, they are doing their own fun. This was a problem in this system also. Which system? System under VAT. So VAT, once in what happens in the VAT, you know, again Kelkar committee, they propose that, you know, you should not do this. States should not be given a power to enact a law. States should not have power to enact law because every state will do their own manmani. Right? At their will, they'll pass act. And that is not a true sense of doing business in India. That's a hurdle, that's a bottleneck for India. And to ignore or to remove this effect, let us form a joint committee. This was the idea given by Kelkar committee. Let us form a joint committee where state finance minister will come together. All state finance minister will come together. They will prepare the law and that law will be passed by parliament first and then subsequently it will be approved by state government. Now state government will have their own law but in consultation of central government. And they brought transparency in India under value added tax, white paper law. What was the white paper, sir? White paper means fundamental principles to enact sales tax law in your state. So you make your own law, no matter. But there are these principles written, 10 points, which should be there in your act. And that was white. That was a white paper law, which is known famously as value added tax. Right? Finance minister of West Bengal was the head of this committee. Das Gupta, Mr. Das Gupta, right? Asim Das Gupta, and he headed the finance ministry. And in 2004, maximum state adopted VAT system. That means they abolish all these three existing system. And what I am saying, VAT is the best system that they launch. Now, what you should understand again, If VAT was the best one, then why? GST. That is next page. But are you clear about this old system first? Now, sir, let me show you cascading effect first of all. So some people will understand where is cascading effect, sir. So some people correct it very easily, but my new student might be finding it difficult. See, I should pay tax on value of goods. I should, as a consumer, I should pay tax on value of goods. It is wrong if you charge me tax on value of goods as well as the tax on tax. See, as a consumer, I don't find it difficult or offensive to pay tax on value of goods. That is your right. Government, it is your right to charge tax on my value of goods. But it is wrong if you charge tax on tax. Sir, where is tax on tax? In first situation, this is not tax on tax. But from second situation onwards, there is the tax on tax. How, sir? What is the value of goods? You tell me. He paid how much? 110. In 110, there are two components. 100 rupees is the value of goods and 10 rupees is tax component. And his value addition was? Distributor's value addition was 190. That means, what is the value of this 200? What is the value of goods in this 200 rupees, beta? 190 na, Alex. 190 value of goods. 100 rupees value added by manufacturer and 90 rupees value added by trade distributor. Okay. And 10 rupees is my tax. Are you clear about this bifurcation? Now we are charging 20 rupees tax. And how this 20 rupees came? 10% on 200 rupees. So in 20 rupees there are two components. There are two components. 10% of 190 is the tax on value. And one rupee is tax on. This is the cascading effect. So this person, wholesaler, paid a 20 rupees. He is okay with this 19 rupees. But he is not okay with 1 rupee, because 1 rupee is you are charging tax on tax. Sir, only 1 rupee. Why are you fighting for 1 rupee? Beta, again I am putting here 1 crore. I am just writing data in crores. 1 crore. Now, do you feel that pinch? Yes. Yeah. Now, this is how they were doing it. What happens in this case, again, if people are not clear about it, I am teaching again here. Out of 220 rupees, you tell me what is the value of goods? 200. Not 200. See, here they charge 20 rupees tax and here they charge. That means out of 220, as of now, we had paid 30 rupees tax, which is included in 220. That means what is the value of goods? Can you see here? 190 only, right? So value of goods is 190. What is his value addition?
80.
So what is total value of goods in this 300? 270. Total value of goods is 270. Okay, total value of goods? 270. Then total tax involved in 300? 30. And this guy is paying 30 rupees. Can you tell me bifurcation of this 30 rupees? 27 is the tax on value. Whereas 3 rupees is a tax on tax. Am I clear? That means, sir, here also I paid, as a consumer, look at me now. Here also I paid a tax on tax. Here also I paid tax on tax. Here also I am paying tax on tax. Aray, sir, are you mad or what? Every time there is a sale, I am paying tax on value and I am paying tax on tax. And this is the major demerit that we had in old sales tax system. Only because of this demerit, they launched tax called value added tax. And GST is also value added tax. So whatever I am saying is not useless. This problem we had in old law, to solve this problem we launch GST or we launch value added tax. You can say GST is the value added tax, only name has changed, some fundamentals have changed. Okay. Next chart below this, I wanted to prepare for GST, but I cannot prepare here because I don't have board. So you please complete up to this and then we will go for continuation. So this chart has to be there in continuation. So you take page according to you. Understood, beta? There are more 7-8 lines will come under this chart. 7-8 lines. Okay? Can you pause this?